Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cub Fans Minecraft. This is episode 40. And today I think we're going to do some a little bit of cosmetic changes around the world. As you can see here, I'm just burning up some brick. I think I'm going to go ahead and if we go outside here, we'll make this cobblestone generator we have over here into a sort of like a furnace type thing, and I want to have some netherrack burning in there, so it'll be like a brick furnace type deal here. So I'm gonna continue smelting this brick in the house. In the meantime, let me see if I have an axe on me. I don't. We're gonna go ahead and harvest some of this wood and see if this system works here. Let's see if anything has just fallen off randomly in the last 5 minutes. Nope. So we're going to harvest some wood, and we're also going to make some cosmetic changes to the tower and inside the house. So I'll be back once this brick is smelted quite a bit. Okay, everybody, as you can see, we got some brick down here in our inventory. So we're going to go ahead and head out and see if we can't make it sort of in the same style as this building. But I'd like to have the whole cobblestone structure itself completely enclosed, and then hopefully have like a piece of netherrack in there to simulate like being like a furnace type of thing. So we'll just go ahead and break this. We'll put the netherrack in here if we can, and then we'll just put something around like this, sort of all the way around. I think it would be pretty cool. And I'll go ahead and continue doing this. It's gonna be kind of a boring process, but you know how it is. Looks like we're doing all right on time here. And we don't want these vines growing down, so we can also probably get rid of this. And I should probably craft an axe, because we're going to be going over there to harvest some of our wood pretty soon here. So let's see. Just like that. Around here. Alright, that seems like it's pretty decent. Not quite symmetrical, but I think it will be alright. So I'll put that there, and then I'll just make like a little house, or a little storage place up here. And let's see, do we need to... No, we don't need this to be very high, so I can just go ahead and put this on like this, and we need a lot more brick. Darn it. Alright, everybody, we're up here on the third floor of my house. I thought I might as well just go ahead and craft a new item while I'm at it, because we need something to light this netherrack. So I'm going to go ahead and try and craft the new fire charge to use to light stuff on fire. And I think that's crafted using a blaze rod, a piece of charcoal, so let's grab, or a piece of coal rather. And let's see, what else do we need? Gunpowder? Yeah. See, I know we have plenty of that. There we go. Alright, so the fire charge, I think it's blaze, gunpowder, maybe that. There we go. 3 fire charge. Nice. And I'm not sure if these actually are used up when you light them on fire or not, so we'll have to just take a minute and see once we get that done. So, collecting the rest of these bricks, making a few more bricks, and then I think we're pretty much ready to go. 35, that should be a decent amount. There might be a skeleton out here somewhere, perhaps, hiding in the shadows. Nope, guess not. Huh. Alright, well, back over to this brick area here, the brick furnace, which is our cobblestone generator. We'll go ahead and put the netherrack right in here, and then we'll use the fire charge on it. Oh yeah, so it did use the whole fire charge, so that's good to know. Let's see, let's go ahead and put this like that, and then we'll just do, oh whoops, this thing is intersecting the redstone here, so let's get rid of this. There we go. Okay, we'll put, we'll just make this roof 3 high here, I guess. Might as well, what the heck. Which means we might need a little bit more brick still. Unless this provides us with some that we need. Let's just get rid of all this. We don't need that. And let's see, I don't think we need this either, do we? Oh yeah, we do. Whoops. Okay. Alright, so put that there, and then we'll just keep on working on this here. Let's go ahead and put this like that. That might look pretty cool. And then we'll just work this thing over here. Like that. And hopefully we have enough to go all the way around. Looks like we're just short here. And we don't want that on our building. Okay. Let's see how this looks from the front. So I think that looks pretty cool. And then if we mine it, you know, should still work. Maybe not. Oh, we cut it off, didn't we? That's right. So we gotta get back in here. Hit the button again. Now it's working again. Okay. Got it. There we go. Alright, sweet. Let's go ahead and put this wood, this dirt down here. And let's fill in these last few things there. And now let's see it work, see how it looks. Eh, that looks alright, I guess. Kinda cool. Might want to even out the distribution of brick here. So we gotta go in and get some more. And I'll be back once it's almost completely done. Alright everybody, I have crafted a few more bricks and done a little more work over here. So the plan is to try and make this thing as symmetrical as possible. So I think what we need is to, let's see, we need to first light these other two, whoops, not throw it on the ground like an idiot. Light these other two nether racks like that. And then we need to put some bricks here. And some steps right here in front, and then I think that should be pretty much it. Yeah, so I think that looks pretty good. And let me just make sure it's, oh, not quite done over here. Just gotta get some roof, finish this roof, and I think that's pretty much it. And I'll just show you, I put some torches in there so that mobs don't spawn here. Even though I think the light from the lava and the redstone signal itself will be alright. Or would have been alright by itself. But now we have a sort of brick furnace type thing. So it automatically outputs cobblestone. And I think it's pretty cool. Kind of a nice little addition here. Makes stuff look nice. It's pretty neat. I might actually go ahead and replace this with sandstone though. This, these five bricks here. But I think it's good for now. So next up, I think we should eat something. And then we should go test out this this tree farm, see if it's working. And nope, look at that. Looks like a tree is spazzing out and going through the glass, actually. So let's go craft an axe, and we'll cut down some of the wood in this tree farm. So if we head inside here, we also need to do something about this door not closing behind us. We have a pressure plate. Yeah, we have one. So let's craft another pressure plate real quick here. There we go. So let's put this down. Da da da. Alright. There, let's test it out. That works. We could probably also put one over there. That way I don't even need these buttons anymore, really. Makes it a lot more convenient. And over here, eh, what the heck, we could use one over here too, I guess. So we'll craft one, put it in our hotbar, Boom. Get rid of this. Sweet. So now we have easy access to get out of our house if we need to leave quickly for some reason. And let's see, what else do we need? Let's see, what else do we want to do this episode? I wanted to... Oh, right, this. This automatic wheat farm. I think it might be close to being done, but I wanted to try something special with it. I hate when that happens. Shut down again. Come on. Good lord. There. Okay. So, yeah, I wanted to try something special. So, this is with another new item, the redstone lamp. So let's go ahead and head up, get some glowstone, and it looks like we have plenty here. So let's craft some glowstone blocks, I think. Unless it's just that. No, it's not that. What an idiot. Alright, so let's get some glowstone blocks here. I think we only need 8. Yep. And then if we surround these with redstone. Yep, there we go. Some redstone lamps. So we need 8 of these. There's 5. So do we have any more redstone in here? No. Is this on? No. I need to install a T-flip-flop down there. I'll probably do that probably in one of the next few episodes. So that way we can get rid of these levers and put buttons there. And have it work from any floor regardless of its current state. So stay tuned for that. That's really a simple fix. I just don't want to dig up the floors to fix it right now. Where did I put my redstone at? Did I miss it back here? When I was jabbering? Yeah, I did. Okay, so we'll put this in the center. Redstone all around. There we go. So we have 8 redstone lamps now. So now we need a bit of cobble. Actually, we're going to go ahead and tower up with dirt, because that's what we have the most of. So we'll put this back. Get a few stacks of dirt. Good enough. Have a shovel. Excellent. Okay. So what I'm planning to do here is... Let's see. There's a redstone torch there. So if I go up, there's going to be one... Let's see. Let's just go ahead and start towering up, and I'll show you what I mean by making some cosmetic improvements here. So this one is currently on, so that one's off. Okay. Let's see, so this one is... That one's on. So this one, there should be a redstone torch behind this thing, and it should be off. It is. Sweet. So I'm going to go ahead and put a redstone lamp down there. And what this will do is it'll give us an indication of when these torches are on. So when we turn on this lever, these things will light up. And I'm going to put one at every spot where there's one of these torches that are currently off. And it'll just give us a cool visual indication that our farm is working. Alright, so this one's on. So it should be here. Sweetness. Alright, and I'm just going to keep on going up. Hopefully I don't fall off and die. And hopefully the sun's not getting too low. Nope, looks like we're good for right now. So, yeah, I'll just keep putting down these redstone lamps. Alright, so we're way up here at level, I think it's 97.6, okay. And we put down all the redstone lamps, so now it's time to get down from here. And it looks like most of the wheat is actually full, so I might be able to test this thing. So let's see. Let's just head up and see if this thing's full. Full of wheat. Almost full. Might need a bit more time at these upper levels. But maybe not. Eh. I think it's alright. I say we flick it. Yeah. Let me go clear some inventory space, and then we can come out here and see if these lights are gonna work. Alright guys, just gonna go ahead and craft an axe while I'm in here. There we go, brand new iron axe. Very nice. Let's eat something. And then we can head out. Looks like it's getting a bit dark, so let's just go ahead and test this farm. Let's get our sword out just in case mobs start to spawn, because we are on hard difficulty. So, let's see if these redstone lamps light up. Oh, how cool is that? That was sweet. And we're getting a ton of items down here. Wow. Can you see our inventory fill up? Nice. Awesome. Okay, so I'm going to shut this off. And all the lights go off, as you can see. Whoop, did one remain on up there? I think one of them remained on. That's the top one because I don't have a redstone torch attached to that one yet, but that's alright. Stays on, it stays on. So now we have the joy of replanting. Yeehaw. Alright guys, so we got the tower replanted, as you can see, and looks like we missed a level here, actually. Whoops, that wasn't supposed to happen. But we'll just replant this really quickly. I think actually if you stand on this block here, you can reach pretty much every square. So that's a pretty cool feature of this farm. And I ran out of seeds here. Kind of is a pain to replant all this. Takes probably about 2 or 3 minutes, but I think it's well worth it because you cut your time in half of harvesting. If you harvest this way, and let's head out. Hopefully no mobs. There's an Enderman over there. Here's some zombies. Pretty cool. Creeper creeping on me, as always. And let's go ahead and sleep through the night. Alright, let's go ahead and get rid of this guy. He's just getting on my nerves. Weak. Whoa. Uh-oh, I looked at him. Oh god. Oh god, I just looked at the Enderman. Yikes. This is not good. Don't want to get too close to the edge because he might knock me off. What if he just comes back like years later? Not literally years. Oh, there he is. Oh god. I see him. He seems to not be too upset at me at the moment, with me at the moment. And I'll take that. Okay, so we got this axe. Let's go ahead and head on into our tree farm and see what kind of damage we can do in here. So again, this is a automatically harvesting tree farm. Well, not automatic harvest. It's more of an automatic drop collector. So all we gotta do is knock out each and every one of these trees. Alright, sweet. And you'll notice that I can't hit this dirt block up here. That's intentional. It should be one above how far you can reach. So just get rid of all these trees, then all their drops should start falling. We should get a bunch of tree saplings, a bunch of apples, and it'll be good. And as you can see, a lot of these trees, almost all of them, are fully grown, so perfect. We should get a lot of wood from this. And I think I'm gonna go ahead and so that's the first row. And let's see if some of these things drop stuff. Well, I'm just gonna go ahead and cut it and go ahead and keep on harvesting here. It's pretty monotonous. It's just gonna be me harvesting wood, so just imagine me doing that for the next 5 or 10 minutes, and I'll be back. Alright everybody, so went ahead and cut down all these trees in the farm, and looks like there's quite a number of saplings dropping. There's some that drop around the edges here, but that's not really a problem, as we can just run around and collect those manually. And let's see, looks like there's a few saplings and an apple over here. And then we can head down and see what kind of goodies we have down in the auto collector. So let's head down there and see what we got. And looks like we got some wood. Some, had a few apples down here. And here comes a few more saplings. So I'm just going to wait here for a minute or two and see what all we collect. Okay, everybody, looks like we have a few more saplings coming down here. So I'm just going to go ahead and jump down, stand here, and wait for the rest of them to come down. So it looks like we got 39 saplings, 4 apples. And I think that's pretty much going to be it. Well, there's a few more decaying leaves here. Just make sure there's nothing. There's a sapling. There's an apple that dropped. Let's see if that makes it all the way down here. Should see it come down. Here's a sapling. So everything from this farm, with the exception of the few items that land on the dirt paths where the trees are, and on the sides, will end up here. So it's relatively efficient. Not the greatest system in the world, but for our purposes, I think it's pretty good. So I still haven't seen that apple come down. Let's venture down here and see if anything is getting stuck anywhere. I don't think it should be, but it never hurts to check. Let's see what we got. Nothing getting stuck there, nothing getting stuck there. Yeah, so I think we're good there. Not sure what happened to that apple, though. Let's see. Ah, I see. Looks like it was over here. Yep, there it is. So it's probably a good idea for me to run around here for a little bit to collect some of the stuff that didn't fall in the water. And I'd say that's pretty good. That's a good amount of materials. So I'm just going to go ahead and replant some of these trees. See if we can get them out. There we go. 47. That's a pretty good haul of trees. Tree saplings. Alright. There's that row. And I'll continue to plant these. And do one final harvest. And I'll be back. So going down here for one more time. Got a few more saplings. And I'm going to call that pretty much good for right now. And look at that. One of our trees is already grown. So that's working relatively well. Got the cobblestone generator over there. I still need to cover up this sugarcane farm back here. But right now, I think what I need to do is really go mining for resources. But first, let's go ahead and check out our netherwart farm. We haven't been there in quite a while. Let's take the elevator up. Why not? There we go. Up we go on the elevator. And again, I'll be putting a key flip-flop down here pretty soon. So that way we can start and stop it from anywhere. So let's just make sure I have armor. Good. And let's head into the nether. Check on our netherwart farm. Haven't really been spending too much time in the nether. And looks like it might be ready to harvest. At least one of them. We have the inventory space for it. Gotta be really careful of ghasts out here because, again, we're on hard difficulty. And looks like this one might be ready to harvest. Not sure about this guy. This guy needs a little bit more, but this guy might be ready to harvest and replant at least some of it. Yep, let's go ahead and try it. So if we hit this button, all falls off. Run and collect it. 23 nether wart. So when we put this back down, so we run across here. We had a net gain of 12. So that's good. And this one looks like it's still on its way. Let's see. I'm gonna want a bit more soul sand, so let's go ahead and come down here. Get this shovel and just grab a couple pieces of soul sand. Don't need a whole lot. And I'm gonna utilize this to make a boat dock launcher, or a launcher for a boat dock that I'm planning on making soon. So let's go ahead and head in, and I'll go back to the overworld, and we can go ahead and get started on this boat launcher soon. So back at Mushroom Portal, got some soul sand. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and go down and sleep, and we'll get started on the boat dock tomorrow. Alright everybody, so I went ahead and put down my wood we got from cutting down the trees in the tree farm. I've crafted so far 2 redstone torches, 2 redstone lamps, got my soul sand. Should probably go ahead and craft my bread from the wheat we got, just to condense down my inventory a bit, because it's getting a bit full at the moment. So let me just do that real quick. There we go. And let's see, what else are we going to need? We're going to need some pistons. So I think we only need 2 pistons. So let's just put some of this stuff down. There we go. Actually, we'll need 3 pistons. My bad. 3 pistons. There we go. And we're going to need to make one of them sticky. Da 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 da. Slime ball. Awesome. Fortunately, this world has a lot of slimes down in that ravine by our house. So we didn't have to worry too much about that. Let's see, we have some redstone. What else do we need? I'm going to make this out of sandstone. So let me go to the desert. I'll make a shovel if I don't have one already. Let's just check these chests. I know I have a damaged one in my hotbar now, but could probably use another one. So let's make some more sticks, make a shovel, and we'll head out to the desert and get a bunch of sand to make some sandstone so it'll look all nice and pretty. Okay, everybody, so I just got back from the desert, got a bunch of sand, so I might as well go ahead and start making that into some sandstone. I think 32 should be more than enough, but might as well just get 16 more. And my inventory is an absolute mess. Let me clean it up real quick and I'll be back. Okay, everybody, we're going to need quite a few pressure plates. As you see, I cleaned up my inventory a bit here. So we'll just get these stone, and we're going to need 5 pressure plates here. But other than that, I think we have everything we need, so let's check the time. We might be able to go out and back and get started right now. Yeah, let's go ahead and try and get started. So I want to make it back here pretty close to the sugarcane farm. Maybe right here would be nice. Yeah, somewhere in this area. Right here is fine, actually. Let's go ahead and do it right here. So we're going to put down... Go ahead and dig back a little ways. Going to need a... Let's see. Let's put down a 3x3 area here. Alright, I'm just kind of coming up with this on the fly. So, let's see. Need to dig out a 3x3 canal type thing. Like that. And then we'll dig down one more. And we'll put down some sandstone blocks. Like that. And then we'll put down some pressure plates, which should, I believe, stop the water. Yeah. Okay, cool. So then we can dig this out. Put some sandstone down. And then we'll need another pressure plate there. Then dig out the next row. Again, put sandstone down to make it look nice. But here we'll need to dig down underneath this thing. And we'll put redstone. Yeah, it looks like it's getting a bit dark. Redstone there. And there. And for right now, I'm just going to tower up here. And go inside to sleep, because monsters are going to be spawning any second now. Alright guys, so we're back. So what we need to do is we need to dig down right here. So here is our redstone. It's going to go to our sticky piston, which should face straight up at us. And then we're going to put our soul sand block right on top of that. So when we step on this, when our boat comes in, we hit this pressure plate. This thing should shoot up. And I believe since boats... can hit soul sand and not break, this should stop it from breaking. So that's our way to get into the port, so to speak. And we're going to need one more pressure plate here, just in case we come in with a lot of momentum. So we'll put that guy down here. And then what we need is to clear a bit more land around here, first of all. Like that. Should be good. And we'll clear off this and that. Perfect. Okay, so make sure this guy works. He does. Alright. And let's see. What do we need here? We need We need like a button type thing here. So we'll put our button there. We'll put our two pistons on the sides. Like so. Piston there. Piston there. And let's put a redstone torch here. And a redstone torch there. And we'll put a button, which I neglected to craft, but I think I have some back at the inside the house. There. Then we need to just cover this up. And we also need a... Let's see, we need something to close the water in here. Let's see. Nope, don't want that there. Something like this should work, I think. Like that. We don't want that down there, so we'll put stuff down there and down there. So that water should come down there. Whoop. This water should go down there. Just drop down and put something there. There we go. Just make it look sort of nice. And might as well just fill this in with cobble as well. And then one right there. Let's see, this should, and I reiterate, should work as a boat dock that both deploys and can take in the boats. So we put water down there, it should flow down. So okay, so how this works is, boat comes in, hits there, this, and that doesn't really work, does it? Ah, right, because I didn't hit that. I see. Let me go get a button and we can simulate how this works. Okay, so I went ahead and got a button. I also have some wooden planks, so let's go ahead and craft our boat. And what the heck, let's just get two of them just to be safe. In case one of them breaks the first time. Alright, so we're heading out back to our boat dock over here. And this should be able to both launch and receive boats. So let's go ahead and put our button down. The button goes right in the center here. And what the heck, we might as well dig some of this out and put some sandstone down. Just to make it look all nice and pretty. There we go. That looks better. And we'll do the same on this side, because why the heck not? I also got some redstone lamps, which I thought would be pretty cool to see up here. To be sort of a like a lighthouse type thing. Actually, I think it should go there. Yeah. Sweet. All right. One there, one there, and we can probably put one in the middle if we want to. I'd probably make it look a lot better. But yeah, so this is what it looks like. Let's go ahead and put that there. And we'll put one here as well. There we go. Cool. So this should be the boat dock pretty much done. Let's test it out. So if we get a boat, put it down here. And let's get rid of these lily pads, because these things are like mines for ships. For boats. Okay, let's try it out. So if we come down here, and it stops. And as you see, we didn't break the boat. And we can destroy it if we want to, like that. But then let's put one down in here and see if we can get it out. So we hit it. Water comes out. And we have to hit the boat. That was a little bit of a derp moment there. Let's turn it around. Head back. Let's try it one more time. So we come in here. So that worked. Now to get it back out, we hit this button. And we have to hit it on the way out. And there we go. Sweet. That works. So that's a nice little boat system there. And I think this might connect to a larger ocean out here. I'm not really sure. Yeah, it hooks around here and then keeps going. I should probably craft a map pretty soon. So yeah, that's cool. It's an automatic boat dock that can transfer your boat from land to sea and from sea to land. So, awesome. And I hit a lily pad. God dang it. So yeah, that's pretty cool. And you know, I might make this a little more nice looking. I might put another redstone lamp there in the future, just to make it look nice and pretty. Can also go ahead and, for now, put some sandstone over top of this water so you don't see that. And let's just go ahead and get rid of this. Yeah, so that's our boat dock. Cool. Alright everybody, and just for the heck of it, I thought I would get out my map. I actually already crafted one, but I just haven't been using it a whole lot, as you can see. And I thought we could go ahead and get in our boat and just go on a little adventure. I'm going to try and make it back to the second base over there and show you a small little change I did with regards to the upside down stairs. So let's go ahead and get the boat out. Place it down there. So we need to stand out over here, hit the button, out goes the boat, and we're in it, and we're off. So let's take a look at this map, see what kind of ground we're covering, and I'm gonna explore this way a little bit. Hopefully it rings around back to where that desert area. I think it does. Looks like it does. Avoiding lily pads all the way. Uh-oh, here comes one. Oh, got it just in time. So, yeah, I'm going to head toward my secondary base, and I'll be back once I get there. So here we are, roaming the seven seas, destroying lily pads. There's a lot of them out here, too. I don't know if squid will break the boat. Oh, well, squid that pushed me into lily pads will definitely break the boat. So here's how far we've come so far, and the sun is setting. I think we're not too far from our secondary base, though, so I think I can make it. Here's a good bit of clay here. Just gotta get out of this water here. And we gotta get over there fast because it is getting dark. So, let me just run this way. I think we're pretty much even with it. Our main base is back that way. So let's see where we're at. Okay, I think we go this way. Yep, so here we are. Some mobs have already spawned. We gotta fight these guys off. Shouldn't be too difficult. Except that, might get ganged up here. Yep, okay. Gotta get moving. Don't want to stay down here too long. So if we make our way back up to the, secondary base. Let's have a look at our map. Oh yeah. It's pretty cool. We're making some ground. Mapping some terrain. Mapping out some areas we might want to explore later on. Found a bunch of clay over there. In that ocean biome. So if we head in here. Head up. Here we go. So the change I made in here is that I switched the direction of all these once again. They're now... they have sort of like a smooth surface instead of the jagged surface that what it looked like before when I had the stairs upside down. These are all right side up. These are still upside down, however. And I think it just gives it a nice smooth look. Plus you can jump up here and just like survey the land. So yeah, it's that's pretty cool. The only other thing I have to say is that I'm getting a little bit low on resources, both at my main base and here. I just need some more redstone, things like that, so I can make some other cool redstone builds. And I think I'll probably, in the next few episodes, make sort of a one or two different melon farms slash pumpkin farms. I might make an ice base over in this tundra biome near my zombie grinder, my XP grinder. And I also have some cool pixel art I might show you guys. I have one or two ideas that I think are pretty cool. and I'm probably gonna put something over my my bridge over my main base. So those are some of the things that are coming on in the next few episodes. These are still upside down. See how bad that looks? This is much cleaner. So I'll probably have to fix this too. I might as well just go and do that right now. But yeah, so thank you very much for watching, guys. Hope you liked this episode. Let me know if you think I can improve anything, or if you didn't like something, or if something was epically awesome. Other than that, though, thanks for watching. This has been CubFan. Goodbye.